The pumpkin drop is something that the physics club has been doing for several years now. It started a few years back with the students, and Professor Dupree came up with the idea. Students start out carving whatever they want into it. A lot of times they have physics themes. Sometimes people carve symbol pi, so you can have some pumpkin pie. Other things include the Schrodinger equation, faces.
I usually go for the biggest one. It's the most fun because it explodes more, but you usually go for the weird ones.
Last year, I got one that looked kind of like a goose, and so I painted it like a goose, and it fell very strangely.
And it didn't break.
Didn't break at all.
Which was the funniest part of it, actually.
It was a lot of fun.
Students will toss them up in the air, drop them out the window, right from our conference room in Schaefer Hall. This year we recorded the pumpkins falling, and we've analyzed them to measure the acceleration due to gravity with video analysis, just like students do in their first year courses. But also we learn about things by smashing them.
Basic physics that you learn in college, it's maybe like the fundamentals that you learn in your first years here. So it's really cool to see it applied in practice, I guess, to see what we're learning in class, so that's also fun.
You don't have to be like an upper level physics major to understand it or anything.
Yeah, and the software that Professor Grossman uses to actually track it is actually really cool to see too, so some of the technology that's involved is really fun to play with.
We used just a regular web camera to record the motion of the pumpkin so we can have the software track the position of the pumpkin and monitor it frame by frame. And then as we do this, we can see that it goes up as time passes and comes back down. And with each passing interval of time, it travels more and more as it accelerates downwards. This motion of the pumpkin under constant acceleration, that's free fall, is one of the simplest kinematic situations. So it's a really good place to start looking at things. This is something we encounter all the time. Everything from falling objects, when you throw a ball, when you launch artillery, when you have an electron accelerating between charged plates in a cathode ray tube, like an old TV, something like that. But this idea of a constant acceleration is a great place to start learning about motion.